Understanding is very important in every aspect of life. Understanding is very key because understanding helps you to become outstanding. I would like us to watch this video attentively as Dr. Olumide Emmanuel will be sharing with us 10 major things that will help you to have understanding about real estate and how to become a millionaire through real estate investment. Festus Dadagbon is my name, CEO Chulen Properties. If you are coming across this video for the first time, don't forget to share, comment or like. And I would like you to be a blessing to other people. Share this video to your friend, your colleagues, so that they can be, so you can be a blessing to them. After listening, God bless you as you do that.
I want to talk to you about understanding the power of real estate investment. Now, understanding in life is very, very important. In any aspect of life, understanding is very key because understanding helps you to become outstanding. Understanding is that which is under upon which you stand. Wherever you lack understanding, you will not be outstanding. And when it comes to the aspect of real estate investment, a lot of people lack understanding. And because they lack understanding of how to leverage and maximize the possibilities of real estate investment, they are not able to do what needs to be done. When you study rich and wealthy people all over the world, you will find out that numerous people have used real estate to become rich and wealthy. A lot of rich and wealthy people today, real estate has helped them to achieve riches and to create wealth. There are a lot of people all over the world today that are financially free. Real estate has not only helped people to become rich and wealthy, it has also helped a lot of people all over the world to become financially free. When you look at a lot of retirees today, you'll find out that one of the major differences between those who retire poor and frustrated and those who retire rich and excited is real estate. A lot of people that have retired and they are enjoying their retirement is because they have activated and maximized the power of real estate. Imagine if you spend 25 to 30 years of your life working. Some of you are in your 20s, some of you are in your 30s, some of you are in your 40s. You are already working. Some of you, before you know it, you have been working for 5 years. Some of you have been working for 10 years. Some of you have been working for 15 years. And you don't even have a plot of land to your name, talk less of a house. And before you know it, 10 years time, 15 years time, you are going to retire. Are you going to be depending on the mega gratuity and the mega pension you're going to be getting? No. Imagine that you have 5, 10, 15 houses or apartments that will be bringing you rent and cash flow after retirement. Can you see how that will make your life different from that of other people? So it is very, very important for you to understand that real estate is very, very powerful. Now, so let me talk to you about 10 major things that will help you to have understanding about real estate, because you need to plug into real estate. You need to plug into real estate. If there is anything you need to take advantage of, is real estate. So number one, real estate is a very powerful vehicle of wealth creation. Number one, I'm sharing 10 things with you. Number one, real estate is a very powerful vehicle of wealth creation. If you are going to create wealth, the word wealth creation is wealth creation. So wealth is created. It does not just show up. It has to be created. So in order for wealth to be created, there has to be a creator. There has to be ingredients. There has to be a process. And then you end up with wealth creation. So real estate is a very powerful vehicle of wealth creation. So you want to create wealth. One of the things that you need to understand is that there is a place called your present financial status, and there is a place called your desired financial destination. So to move from your present financial position to your desired financial destination, you need wealth creation vehicles. And there are a lot of vehicles that you can adopt to help you to move from point A to point B. But one of the most powerful of those vehicles is real estate. You can decide to go into entrepreneurship, which is very powerful. You can decide to go into the capital market or money market, very powerful. You can decide to go into invention and create your own wealth through invention, through your own intellectual property. That's very powerful. But unfortunately, majority of people in life want to become wealthy by going to work. So they are trying to go and become rich through salary. You can't become rich through salary. If you decide to use job or paid employment as your track to the wealthy place, it's like somebody trekking. You are going to spend years doing that and you will still not arrive. So number one, real estate is a very powerful vehicle of wealth creation. Number two, real estate is not just a powerful vehicle of wealth creation, it is also a very powerful vehicle of wealth retention. Because it's not just enough to create wealth, it's very, very important for you to be able to retain the wealth. So when you say somebody is rich, somebody is wealthy, it's not only about money, it's about assets. True wealth is asset-based, not cash-based. True wealth is asset-based, not cash-based. Because no matter the cash that you have, inflation can mess up your cash. No matter the cash that you have, market forces can mess, a lot of things can mess up your cash. And you end up having cash that is not as powerful as it used to be. For instance, if when COVID-19 lockdown started in February, March, you had 10 million naira in your account, I hope you know that that money has depreciated drastically by virtue of COVID-19. You know why? When COVID-19 started and the lockdown began in March, a dollar was $360 to a dollar. So if you had 10 million, your 10 million naira would have gotten you about $30,000, some 20 something thousand dollars. But guess what? Right now, for you to get dollar, you are talking about 500 naira to a dollar. So your 10 million that will get you 30,000 just 3 months ago can only get you 20,000 now. So even though you think you have 10 million, because your money is in cash, is losing value. But imagine that you bought a plot of land in that same February and you bought it for 10 million. Do you think the plot of land will still be 10 million? No. You will have retained the value of that your 10 million and it will have even increased regardless of COVID-19, regardless of what's happening everywhere. So number one, real estate is a powerful vehicle of wealth creation. Number two, real estate is a powerful vehicle of wealth retention. So if you want to retain your wealth, you need to have assets in real estate. All the over 90% of rich and wealthy people all over the world use real estate to retain their wealth. So when they are talking about their assets, they are not talking primarily in cash. They are talking about what? They are talking about the assets that they have been able to acquire. And the asset is increasing. An asset is anything that appreciates in value and continues to bring income into your life. So you bought shoe, you bought car, all the cars that you bought, what has happened to the cars in the last 2, 3, 4, 5 years? The very minute you drive the car out of the dealership or out of the car shop, it begins to lose value. But real estate is a very powerful vehicle of wealth retention. Number three, real estate is very powerful because it does not increase. What do I mean by that? You cannot have more lands than we have had. When the entire universe was created, this world that you and I live in right now, the same size of land 10,000 years ago, 300,000 years ago, the same size of land is the same size of land. So real estate is so powerful because you can't have more than you already have. The same size of real estate that we had at the beginning is the same size that we have till now. Now, think about it. Right now, we have close to 8 billion people on the face of the earth. There was a time when we had less than 1 million people on earth. There was a time when we had less than 1 billion people on earth. When we had 1 million people, the size of the land was the same. The earth is a circle. It's the same size. When we had 1 billion people, the size of the land is the same. When we had 5 billion people, the size of the land is the same. Now we have close to 8 billion people. The size of the land is the same. What does that tell you? Land will forever appreciate, no matter what. Land will never depreciate. Real estate will not depreciate. You know why? Because we'll be having more people that will be needing that same small plot of land. Look at Lagos, for instance. There was a time when Lagos just had 4 million people. There was a time when Lagos had 9 million people, 11 million people. Now they are saying Lagos has 20 million people. But has the size of Lagos increased? No. That's why people have pushed into Ogun State, all the border, all the different regions close to Lagos. People have moved in there. And that's the same thing all over the world. So you need to understand that real estate is so powerful because it's not going to increase. So no matter what, you need to plug in as soon as you can. Because if you don't plug in today thinking I will buy later, the price will forever increase. So you'll be doing catch up. You'll be doing catch up. Before you go and save money, it was okay, I will save 500. Before you save 500, it has become 700. By the time it's okay, let me go and save 700, it has become 1 million. Let me save 1 million, it has become 2 million. That's why people have been doing catch up for generations. Number four. Real estate continues to increase in value without any effort from your side. Real estate is so powerful because once you buy a plot of land, whether you do something with it or not, it just continues to increase in value without any effort of your own. And that's why you need to begin to understand, because when I show you the opportunity to become a millionaire, it is based on you understanding this power of real estate. So that when you go out there to maximize the opportunity I want to plug you into now, you'll be speaking from a place of understanding. So whether you have money to buy land or not, you are going to be a millionaire before 31st December if you listen to what I'm about to tell you and you follow it. You'll be amazed. I'm telling you something that has happened. There are testimonials all over the world. In this country alone, we have over 1,000 people that have become a millionaire just by the same thing I want to share with you, the same opportunity I want to give you. If you think you can or you think you can't, you are right. It's what you think that matters. If you believe you can or you believe you can't, you are right. It's what you believe that matters. Number four, so it continues to increase in value. Number five, real estate does not expire. Real estate does not expire. So you can't have a plot of land and say, it has expired. No, it doesn't expire. It's forever. That's why the plot of land that is existing today has been existing before you were born. So you need to understand that real estate, it doesn't expire. The business has gone bankrupt. Stock market has crashed. Real estate does not go bankrupt. It does not crash. It's there. It's just going to continue to increase. Number six. Real estate has a tripartite possibility. It has what? A tripartite possibility. Sir, what do you mean by that? Now listen, when you have a plot of land, guess what? Everything under the ground is possibility number one. You can dig a borehole and reach water under the ground. There are precious metals under the ground. There's crude oil under the ground. There are all kinds of stuff under the ground. So under the ground, that same land you are buying, under the ground, there is something there. The land itself is valuable. You can farm on it. You can build on it. You can do all kinds of stuff on that land. Number three, whatever you put on the land itself is another level. Whatever you put on the land itself. So what is under the ground? Number one, the ground itself. Number two, what you put on top of the ground. Number three. So anytime you get into real estate, there are multiple possibilities. Number seven, a city today was a village yesterday. A village today will be a city tomorrow. What do I mean by that? A lot of people do not have real estate because they are always thinking of how expensive it is to buy land in the city. Where will I see 10 million? Where will I see 20 million? Where will I see 50 million? Where will I see 100 million? So you find out. So you need to understand that a city today was a village yesterday. Why are people not in real estate? I don't have money. The land I want to buy is the one in the city. When I have money, I will go and buy land in the city. That place you are calling a city was a village 10 years ago, was a village 20 years ago, was a village 30 years ago. So why don't you buy the future now? The future is cheap if you buy it today. Instead of trying to buy in the city that you cannot afford, why not buy in the city of tomorrow that is here to be a city now? So the future is cheap if you buy today. A city today was a village yesterday. A village today will be a city tomorrow. And that is why when you have that understanding, hey, it's a bush, it's a bush, it's a bush. Where is bush? Where is bush? What you are calling a bush today, once development gets in there, before you know it, it's no more a bush. Most of you that have traveled abroad, travel to Europe, travel to America, travel to Asia. If you have traveled all over the world, have you seen a village when you travel abroad? Have you seen a village in London, a village in America, a village in Canada? But there are villages there. Most of the places you go to in America, in London, they are villages. Those are people's villages. But why is it not a village to you? Technology eliminates villages. Technology eliminates villages. The reason why it's not a village is because there is road, there is light, there is water, there is cable, there is internet. So the infrastructures that were brought in turned the village into a city. Now you say you are traveling abroad. But when you are going to your own village in Nigeria now, you will say you are going to the village. The person in Ogbomosho or the person in Mwaya, when they are coming to Lagos, they say they are going to the city. Who told you that Lagos is a city? What makes you call Lagos a city is the fact that technology, there is road, there is light, there are houses. So a city today was a village yesterday. So if you have understanding of real estate, you will buy into real estate and understand that even if it looks like a bush today, it's not going to be a bush forever, but it gives you an opportunity to buy cheap and to plug in. Number 8. Any land. Listen to this now. I'm about to give you the $1 million formula. Any land within a 30 minutes to 1 hour driving distance from the center of the city. Any land within a 30 minutes to 1 hour driving distance from the center of the city will become a part of the city in a maximum of 10 to 15 years. What do I mean by that? Wherever you are, those of you from Ghana, those of you from America, those of you from Australia, those of you from Dubai, those of you from Kenya, Tanzania, I've seen different people now. All of you, think about it. Where is the most expensive land in your city? Think of how much a plot of land costs anywhere you are watching me from now. Wherever the plot of land is, anywhere in the city, do you know what you need to do? Identify that point. 30 minutes to 1 hour driving distance from that point in circumference. Any land that is within 30 minutes to 1 hour driving distance from that center of town will be a part of that town in another 10 to 15 years. It will be a part of that town in another 10 to 15 years. So what does that mean? If you go and buy into that land that you are calling a bush, that you are calling a village, that you are calling far today, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, you will also be in the city. And people will be wondering, how did he get a land in the city? How did he get a land in the city? Many of you that are in Nigeria, you know Okpebi Road. You know Allen Avenue. Okpebi and Allen was a swamp. 30, 35 years ago, 40 years ago, people were not willing to even come near that place at all. But today, now, what has happened? Everybody can, I wish I can have land in GRA. I wish I can have land in Okwebi. Where you are calling Lekki today, Lekki phase one, many of you have forgotten that it used to be Maroko. Lekki ended. Where you have the mobile house, then we have Maroko and all kinds of shanty. They were all driven away. Today, those that bought plot of land there for 2 million, today, plot of land is 200, 300 million. So you need to understand that if you understand this power of real estate investment, then as I show you the opportunity, you will just plug in immediately. You will plug in immediately. Now, number 9. Real estate, once you buy a land, you can do so many things on a plot of land. Okay, Segbenus is giving a testimony. Say, I'm a living witness. I bought land in Ibeju-Lekki 9 years ago. You can see. So, I've seen there was a land we bought in the Lekki area for 200,000 in 2003 or thereabout. 10 years later, the land of 200,000 was over 8 million. What will you do that will turn 200 to 8 million in 8-9 years? Where our church is today, when we bought the land, we bought it for 70,000 naira. Today, if you are 5 million, you can't see a plot of land there. What we turn 70,000 to 5 million just by the land sitting down there. So when you get a plot of land, number 9, you can build a lot of things on it. The plot of land, you can build commercial property on it. You can build residential property on it. You can farm on it. It can be an educational center. All kinds of stuff on that land. Finally, number 10. And then I show you the opportunity. Number 10. You can make millions from other people's land. You can make millions from other people's land. And that's what I want to show you. you can become a millionaire without even owning a plot of land. You can become a millionaire. And that is what I want to show you today. How to become a millionaire through real estate before December. Even though you don't have a plot of land to your name, if you can believe me, like thousands and millions have over the years, between now and December, you will be getting a check of nothing less than a million. If you can just believe and plug in. So, what's the 10th point I want you to know? You can become a millionaire through real estate, even with other people's real estate. It's called leverage.
Thank you for watching. I believe you've learned so much. Thank you, Dr. Olumide Emmanuel. Thank you, sir. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, can you do? If you have not shared, kindly share this video. Concerning the number 10, if you're interested to know more about the number 10 point, you can always reach out to me. I'm available to guide you through about the number 10 if you're interested to know more about it. Thank you. Until I come your way next time. Bye for now.